Hello, my dear students, I am Dr. Nikhil Batra. In my previous video, I have talked about the structure of morphine and IUPAC name of morphine. In the continuity of that, presently I am going to discuss about the SAR of morphine and its analogs. Firstly, we will talk about the meaning of SAR, structure of morphine, and then finally we move on SAR of morphine and its analogs. Structure activity relationship is the relationship between chemical structure of a drug or compound and its biological activity. In other words, we can say it is the concept of linking the chemical structure of a drug with the produced biological activity, and this concept is helpful to establish newer drugs with similar structure having more potency and lesser side effects. This is the structure of morphine. Please take care of the numbering that is being mentioned here, and important structural components are also highlighted here. Now we talk about the SAR of morphine and its analogs. The naturally occurring isomer of morphine is levorotatory isomer. Dextrorotatory morphine has been synthesized, but it is devoid of analgesic and other opioid receptor activities. A number of structural variations or morphine have given many compounds that are available in the form of drugs. SAR of morphine can be divided into below mentioned six components. The first one is the aromatic ring A and the basic nitrogen. Second is substituent present on a nitrogen atom. Third is changes in hydroxyl groups. Fourth one is changes in ring C. Fifth is removal of 3-4 epoxide bridge and morphinans. And the last one will be the 14 hydroxy 6 keto derivatives. Now we talk about the aromatic ring A and basic nitrogen. Both of these features predominantly exist in protonated form at the physiological pH. Both features are present in compounds showing opioid analgesic activity. It means they serve as necessary components and must be present in potent mu receptor opioid agonist. Second part is the substituent present on the nitrogen atom. This particular feature is critical for the degree and type of activity that is displayed by the compound. In general, we can say a tertiary amine is necessary for good opioid activity. Size of substituent present on the nitrogen atom determines the potency of the compound and whether it will serve as the agonist or antagonist. If methyl substitution is present and at the nitrogen atom, then the compound must have good agonist properties. If we increase the size of nitrogen substituent 3 to 5 carbon atoms, then the compounds obtained have antagonistic properties at some or all opioid receptors. If more larger substituents are present on a nitrogen atom, then activity returns to the agonist type. Now the next case is, if phenyl ethyl substituent is present at the nitrogen atom, then the compound is 10-fold more potent as a mu receptor agonist than the corresponding N-methyl analog. This particular discussion can be summarized in the form of table. That is, this is the table. In the second column, various substituents are present, and the fourth column is being representing the different type of pharmacological activity. If methyl group is present at the nitrogen, then the drug is morphine. Obviously, it has the analgesic activity. If ethyl or propyl moieties are present, then there occurs decrease in agonist activity and increase in antagonistic activity. The fourth case is if butyl moiety is present at the nitrogen, then the obtained compound is totally inactive. It means it does not have agonist or antagonistic activity. And further, if we increase the size of the alkyl group, that is, there is the case of pentyl or hexyl, there occurs increase in potency as the agonist. And the last case that we have just discussed about, that is presence of phenyl ethyl moiety, more potent mu agonist compound is obtained. Now the third part is changes in hydroxyl group. A number of structural changes on morphine have given compounds and are available in the form of drugs in this particular category. First example is the codeine. Codeine is the derivative of morphine. It can also be mentioned as methyl morphine. It is a potent antitussive agent. As we can see in the structure, there is the change. This is the change. And what is the change is here? In case of morphine, at third position OH group is present, but in case of codeine, methoxy group is present. That is, remove the hydrogen and attach methyl group, or in other words, remove the OH group, attach the methoxy group, you will get the codeine having potent antitussive activity. Second example is the 3,6-diacetyl derivative of morphine, which is commonly known as heroin. This particular drug rapidly penetrates into the brain after intravenous dose and converts into a potent mu receptor agonist and responsible for euphoric rush. And this is the case. How morphine can be synthesized? Simply, we have to do acetylation of morphine by using acetic anhydride. Both the hydroxyl groups present in the morphine, positions are third position and sixth position. That is, these positions are the third and sixth positions, and the hydroxyl groups present on these positions will be acetylated. That is, morphine will be converted into diacetyl morphine, and this particular reaction increases the hallucination of the morphine. And because of only this reason, acetic anhydride is the controlled chemical in body. What happens, we talk about in body, 3,6-diacetyl derivative of morphine, that is heroin, converts into 6-acetyl morphine. This particular reaction occurs in presence of the esterases enzymes which are being present in the body, in the serum and tissues. And this 6-acetyl morphine has more mu agonist activity than morphine. Now we talk about the next category, that is changes in ring C. Changes in C ring of morphine or codeine lead to the compounds having increased activity. First one is the hydromorphone. Hydromorphone is the 7,8-dihydro-6-keto derivative of morphine. As the name suggests, that is, we have to change at two positions, that is 7,8-dihydro, remove the double bond and replace the hydroxyl group with ketone at sixth position. Then we will get hydromorphone, which is 8 to 10 times more potent than morphine. Second example is the hydrocodone. This is the 3-methoxy derivative of hydromorphone. If we compare the structure of hydrocodone with the hydromorphone, we only need to do only one change, that is at third position. Simply convert the hydroxyl group into the methoxy group. This hydrocodone is more active than codeine. Now the next category is removal of epoxide bridge and the morphinans. Removal of epoxide bridge in morphine gives the compounds that are known as morphinans. This bridge cannot be removed from morphine by synthetic procedure. That is, morphine ends need to prepare by synthetic procedure separately, and which gives compounds as racemic mixtures. Out of this racemic mixture, levorotatory form possess the opioid activity and dextroisomer possess antitussive activity. This is the structure of morphine and ring. Need to remember this structure. Two morphine and derivatives are here. First one is the levorphenol. It is approximately 8 times more potent than morphine as an analgesic. And if we talk about the structure, simply one OH group is present here in comparison to the morphine and ring. Second example is the butorphenol. In this case, there are two structural changes. We need to attach hydroxyl group. This is the hydroxyl group which is present at the 14th position, and need to attach cyclobutyl moiety at the methyl moiety which is present at the 17th position. Butorphenol serves as mu antagonist and kappa agonist. Next category is 14 hydroxy 6 keto derivatives. The opium alkaloid thebaine can be synthetically converted into 14 hydroxy 6 keto derivative of morphine. In general, presence of 14 hydroxy group enhances the mu receptor agonist activities and decreases the antitussive activity. In this particular case, first example is the oxycodone. If we compare the structure of oxycodone with the previous structures, we can consider the three structural changes. The first one is the presence of hydroxyl group at 14 position, presence of ketone group at 6th position instead of OH group, and presence of methoxy group at 3rd position instead of phenolic hydroxyl group. Oxycodone is about as potent as morphine when given parenterally in the body. Second example is the oxymorphone. If we compare the oxycodone and oxymorphone, there is only one change, that is at the position 3rd. In the case of oxymorphone, hydroxyl group is present at 3rd position. Third example is the nalbuphine. This is the structure of nalbuphine. Now, there are two structural changes in comparison to the oxymorphone in nalbuphine. First one is the presence of hydroxyl group. This is of 6 alpha hydroxyl group at 6th position, and presence of N-cyclobutyl methyl moiety instead of N-methyl moiety. Nalbuphine acts through kappa receptors. It has approximately half analgesic potency than morphine, and it serves as an antagonist at mu receptors. Fourth example is the N-allyl noroxymorphone, that is naloxone. In this particular structure, only one component, structural component, is highlighted, that is presence of allyl moiety instead of methyl moiety at the nitrogen atom. Fifth example is the N-cyclopropyl methyl noroxymorphone. As the name suggests, that is presence of cyclopropyl moiety is required at the nitrogen atom. This particular drug is also known as naltrioxone, and both of these drugs are pure opioid antagonists. Both are slightly mu receptor selective and antagonists at all opioid receptor types. तो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अगर आपको ये वीडियो अच्छा लगा हो तो आप इसे लाइक कर सकते हैं, शेयर कर सकते हैं. थैंक्स, आज के लिए इतना ही.